Hey everybody, it's Eric Johnson from Air Today Throws Nation. In today's video, we are going to go through the progression of stand throw to 22 meters featuring video of Ryan Krauser back in 2019. Big meet performance, 74 feet. So hopefully you pull some cool tips. Check it out. Okay guys, so we're in, and one of the things we want to do with today's video is, as we approach the off season, we look at training and we look at the pros. It's always great to emulate the best. We want to try to point out what we think are the key things that those throwers are working on. And one of the core things you can look at is we try to always kind of apply these, what we consider clearly the best technical models. These are some of the greatest throwers in history. And Ryan Krauser, as we had posted up an Instagram clip, that Ryan is the king of 22, right? He's had more throws over 22 meters than any thrower in history and many of the greatest throwers combined. So he is something really special to watch. It's always exciting when you get the opportunity to see him compete and throw. And so what we're going to do is go back, kind of look at some 2019 footage, another big meet performance. He'd been coming off of like a 2270 plus performance, and now here he was again, and in this competition went 2267, so 74 feet. Now, one of the things that we're going to look at is kind of his progression. He goes through a few stand throws, and then you're going to notice that he goes through his progression of fulls, and they're all slightly different. And I think that's the good lesson here, to look at how these throwers kind of approach how they're moving and how meticulous they are about what they want to achieve in that competition. Whereas I think with younger throwers, one of the challenges that they face is that they're still in such a developmental phase, they don't know exactly what to do. So progressions aren't anything revolutionary, but looking at how you're going to hit those specific things in each phase of the progression is really the key. You're going to notice that, you know, Ryan was a glider for much of his youth career. Obviously was a very successful high school thrower, number two all time. He's now the Olympic record holder, and he's a multiple time, you know, world championship competitor. And so one of the things we're going to look at is he does the step into the stand throw. You're going to notice the position of his right foot, right? It's kind of here. We would always say to about 10 o'clock, and this is going to allow him to get, you know, create separation where he's going to shift his shoulders and everything back over. So one of the things we refer to is creating an angle. And the reason is you're going to be able to set the alignment on the angle. You're going to notice where the hips are. So one of the things, this is kind of in line with a lot of what we teach in our throwing chain reaction system. We want to control right hip movement. If the hips are moving with the shoulders, you're not creating separation. So you see that, and you're going to notice where Ryan's elbow is. One of the big things we talk about for rotational shot putters is don't wind the shot. You kind of reach and stretch, and you're going to notice that Ryan creates a ton of separation. So here you're going to notice that as he comes down, you're going to notice that he's on this double bent legs. He's got the left foot open, and we always say open it to about 7 o'clock. So it puts down. It's going to rotate a little bit, and we'll rotate double knees. And now you're going to notice that one of the things that you're going to see is, I didn't play this in full motion, but if I do real quick, you're going to notice that he's not trying to punch it really hard. But right here, you kind of look at the lines. So it's about 18 meters on his first throw. So kind of a key point, he's not trying to get out there and just smash giant stand throws. And that 18 meters, right around 59 feet, nice and easy, 59 foot. And then you're going to notice that as he goes into his second stand throw, you're going to just see him kind of increase the intensity a little bit. And in this one, we're going to look at not just the lower body, but now we're going to look at the block and the delivery side hip. Again, as he kind of comes in, you see him set over. He's going to create, he creates a little bit more separation this time. You're going to notice again the hip position, right? It's not rotating the hips ultra far. And then what you're going to see is, as he comes down, you're going to see again that foot open. See how that foot opens? Again, double loaded legs, arms out nice and wide. He's going to come into the throw, and then you're going to see the block arm stop, right? The block side stops and the hip comes through. That's going to allow him to be able to push the shot out. And then he just puts a little bit more, and then that's going to require a little follow through. So as the hip comes through, because a lot of times you guys out there have a hard time reversing, it's simply a matter of getting the hip all the way through. When that hip comes all the way through, it's very easy to follow through on the throw and be able to create the reverse. So now you look here, now you're looking at the lines. Now he's throwing about closer to about 19 meters, right? So he just went from 59 to 62, nice and easy, just added a little bit more punch to his throw. So now you're going to notice that the next thing Ryan does, he hops in the ring and he's going to move to working on his full throw progression. And so you're going to notice that he just kind of gets everything set. He's working a little taller and you just work, see how he just works around and he's just kind of feeling positions. So he'll get in, he kind of goes through the motion of a full throw and then he's going to come into his full throw. Now, one of the things that we like to point out, now again, we don't know everything Ryan works on. At this meet, I was lucky enough to just have a couple minutes and talk to Ryan, ask him a couple questions, talk to his dad, him and his dad. Dad's primarily his coach, Mitch Krauser. But again, what we're looking at here is just what we see from obvious mechanical standpoint, right? What are the core observations we can make? The thing that we see again here is when he does his first stand, you're gonna notice how tall he is. So one of the things that we've done in our system for a long time, we'll teach our athletes how to move taller because it's a little bit of a more controlled movement and it's easier to move the axis points and the points of rotation. You know, one day, hopefully we'll get a chance to talk to Ryan in detail and ask him some more specifics, but you're gonna notice this again, notice how tall he is. So this is some drill work we do. It's actually real similar to something we've done in our system for a long time called a wind-up one-start. We're really trying to limit a lot of motion and we're just trying to make sure we move smoothly around the axis. Notice that Ryan does the same thing. He's going to come around here and you're going to notice that he really gets that entry side moved around. Nice sweep leg. You notice how he gets this arm open. And the one thing, you know, you get to see Ryan, he really moves through the center of the ring. He's going to stay nice and long. Now he's right back into that stand throw position. This looks really close to what he was warming up with. And I think that's the point. A lot of times guys are just trying to smash giant warm-up throws. And I think what you're going to see more consistently with your advanced throwers and your world-class throwers is that they're trying to set up a stand throw that most mirrors their full throw. And so when you see this here, now you got Ryan right back into the position. So now you're looking at a position where his full throw has moved him into essentially the same exact position that he was in his stand. And so what you're going to see is now the hips coming through, the knees coming forward, the block arm is going to start to engage. It started out nice and wide. You're going to notice again the shoulders, and the thing that we kind of pushed, we looked at a little bit was the hip, the block leg, right? You see how everything's here so that everything comes out and now it's very easy to punch it out. Now again, Ryan was going nice and easy, just putting big throws out there. This is obviously easily, you know, like that 21 meter range. Okay, so now we're gonna go through, he's gone through his first stand throw, it's taller, easy motion. And now you're gonna see that as he comes here again, the classic Krauser setup. This is similar to how we have our athletes set up in the throwing chain reaction. And so, as he comes around, now he's going to be a little bit taller again, and you're gonna see him coming down and around again. And again, we always like to teach that taller feeling because you come around the corner, you can drop and create the sprint. This is a really big dude. As you can see, Ryan is, he's tall, he's extremely muscular guy, he's a massive dude, and he moves like lightning, and that's gonna be really important. So we'll talk about strength in another video. So as he comes around, one of the things you're gonna notice now is how he really keeps the hips moving and keeps the hips under. Everything on his body's moving this way and he's really working into a rewrap, right? So this is what we call like our pillar four in our system. So now he's got the double loaded legs opened up and you're gonna notice again the length of the arm. This is really critical. That block arm is gonna be really important to setting up and kind of leading the path of what we would say the delivery side. So if this is nice and long, that's gonna allow him to move into the throw. You see that? So he moves here again, goes from that long arm position right there, boom, and then you're gonna notice that block is engaging right there, and you're gonna see how everything's gonna move around the block, right? So as he connects everything together and you see that nice extension, again, you see how everything tied back to the stand throw. All right, so now we're progressing into it. I think this is about his fifth throw, and you're gonna notice again, now he's starting to warm up, and he's getting a little bit more squatted, and you're gonna notice now he's starting to move more into his full throw. You're gonna notice he takes this really long path, and so as this goes long, you're gonna create length, and you're gonna be able to move this way. So this is something we've always talked about, Again, you'll hear me mention it. We'll talk about the counterbalance system between the entry arm and the sweep leg. And that's how you're gonna see he comes around nice and long. And the key here is when you enter in, I think this is one of the fundamentally, you get the shoulders a little bit forward. I get a lot of young throwers and they're too upright. So as they rotate, they're kind of falling into the throw. And you're gonna notice that Ryan really is out here. One of the cues we always have taught is, you know, shoulders over the knees in the shot. So we're a little bit forward, and that, there's a really fine point there. You want the knees on top of the toes, shoulders on top of the knees. You don't want to be too far forward because otherwise you're going to push your hips back, and now that's going to cause a whole bunch of problems. You're going to fall into the throw. And again, if you've watched some of the videos and things we've put up recently, we talk about the biggest thing you need to do is create speed, and you have to, in order to do that, you're gonna have to have the right start and the right entry that creates balance. Balance is gonna allow you to create more speed. If you're off balance, you're falling, you're not gonna be able to control the speed of the fall. The fall is what it is. People would talk about as if Ryan speeded up the beginning of the throw. You've heard this mentioned here and there. He's so long, and it's such a long controlled movement. We always kind of use Ryan as the example of the physics of, you got the hinge and the handle. The handle is moving faster than the hinge, technically, because it's covering the same amount of distance in the same period of time. That's how we kind of describe Ryan. Can he move faster? Will he move faster? I bet you he probably will, but it's a long, big movement. So for a long, big guy, it may look slower, but his speed of release is clearly at a very high point. Otherwise, he wouldn't be throwing the distances he's throwing. So his speed of release is always extremely fast. And that's what you notice is my long explanation of saying Ryan does an incredible job always of just being so on balance that he can just create a ton of speed. So once he comes around that corner, he's able to really accelerate and continue acceleration all the way through the finish. As he comes here and you see him come down, you're gonna notice again those hips really move as a unit. He gets into that wrap, he's starting to increase the intensity because he's getting closer and closer to comp time. And right here, I think this was his last throw in warmups, and you can see that last line is 22 meters. So he goes from just taking some nice, easy stand throws and just builds everything up, and now he's throwing, you know, 72 feet, and it's go time, and he's ready to go. And in this particular comp, we'll put that video up on his second throw. He goes 22, 67, 74 feet, and another great 22 meter performance by Ryan. And he had other 22 meter throws in the competition, but 22, 67 was his best on the day. So the point of putting this video up is just kind of look at, when you're looking at the footage of your pros, it's really important to understand that they're doing so many key things right. So I just thought it would be good to look at, when you look at a thrower who's going from a stand throw, look at the intensity, look at the positions that are created all the way to the final throw of his warm-up of a full throw, and kind of see the intensity build, the technical, you know, motion of how he's putting that together, and now he's ready to go. And, you know, sure enough, first throw's big, second throw's bigger. You can see that's what's important for throwers to learn. So many young throwers are coming out trying to smash, they're trying to compete in the warm-ups, and you could see here Ryan's not competing. He's getting himself prepared, and that's ultimately the goal of all young throwers. And remember, at the end of the day, while we do compete against other people, you're always competing against yourself. So it's really important to be able to map your technical patterns and be able to feel the right positions. Again, that's one of the things we do with the throwing chain reaction, and we're always trying to teach people, what do we do at each specific phase of the throw that happens so quickly. So at any rate, hopefully you guys find this helpful. Just we're gearing up, like we said, for that off-season time. We want to be thinking about more technical patterns and developing good mechanics and understanding how that works. So looking at the best is always a great way to do that. So thanks so much, you guys, for watching. Hopefully you liked today's video. Be sure to hit that subscribe button, comment below anything you'd like to see, share this bad boy, and we will see you on the next video.